Welcome to our video series about using fiskaltrust services. In this video we will talk in detail about the contents of a signing request. Before starting this video, make sure you have access to a functional cashbox, and that you have installed a REST or SOAP client. You also need a copy of the fiskaltrust POS interface description. You can download the interface description from the fiskaltrust portal, if you have selected the POS creator role in your account. This document provides the technical specification of the data interface to the fiskaltrust service. In the section, Receipt Structure, of the general part, you can find an overview of the receipt data and composition. The subsection, Receipt Request, of Data Structures lists all fields a signing request consists of. Now we will construct the request body of a simple sales receipt. The request headers, method, and URL are already set, as shown in the previous video. We will only use mandatory fields for the purpose of this video. First we need to set the ftCashBoxID. Fields with the FT prefix are provided by fiskaltrust, and fields with the CB prefix are provided by the cash register. The cbTerminalID contains the unique ID of the cash register the request is sent by. For cbReceiptReference, enter the identifier of the receipt, as provided by the cash register. Enter the time of receipt creation in UTC for cbReceiptMoment. Leave the fields, cbChargeItems, and cbPayItems empty for now. We will fill them later. The ftReceiptCase states the type of business transaction, and is used to choose the right processing logic. This field is of highest importance for the correct processing of the receipt. In the corresponding chapter of the general part, you can find all general flags. Go to the appendix of the applicable country, in our case this is Austria, and navigate to the subsection, Type of Receipt, ftReceiptCase. The first four digits of the receipt case are the country code. For most sales receipts in Austria, you will use cash transaction with RKSV requirement for it. Convert the hexadecimal number to decimal, and enter it for ftReceiptCase. Now we will construct our only charge item. Each charge item corresponds to an item or service on the receipt. Go to the Charge Items Entry subsection of the Data Structures chapter in the general part. Our receipt contains a charge item called Article 1, with the amount 1. The gross total price for this item is 5 units of the country currency, and the VAT rate is 20%. For the FT charge item case, go to the corresponding table in the AT appendix. The first four digits are again the country code. Since we don't know the service type of Article 1 but we know the VAT rate, we will select item case, undefined type of service for AT normal. Convert the value to decimal, and enter it in the request body. Navigate to the general FT pay items section. The pay items declare how the charge items were paid for. In our case this is a cash payment of amount 5. For the FT pay item case, navigate to the corresponding section of your country. We will select cash payment in national currency. Convert this to decimal, and enter it in the body. This is the minimal set of data you need to sign a sales receipt. When you send this request, you will receive a response containing the digital signature. The most important field here is FT signatures. In the Receipt Response section of the Country Appendix you can find an overview of the fields. Move down to the signature entry, and jump to the FT signature format table. Entries with the FT signature type, unknown, contain additional data. The signature is found in entries with the FT signature type, signature according to RKSV, in Austria. The default FT signature format is QR code. In this video, you learned how to construct a signing request for a simple sales receipt, and how to evaluate the response. You can now continue with one of the next videos.